get right today. Just can't seem to get right today. Just can't seem to get right today. I guess I'm gonna give up. Oh, I guess I'm gonna give up. Nearly 20 years since he's been gone. He still sings goodbye songs. Yes, he knows she should move on. But she just can't let him go. No, she just can't let him go. Sorry if I made you wanna cry. Sorry if I made you wanna cry. Wish you know that my mental high. I just see bringing you down. Oh, I just see bringing you down.
This is Ray, and you know, I was thinking, this little story that I'm about to tell you, if it happened today, I could be a millionaire. That's how much things have changed. Used to be teachers ruled. Now teachers are ruled. But this is a story back when I was a freshman. And young and dumb, 15 years old, something like that. I don't know. And I know you've heard the expression, not the sharpest tool in the shed and things like that. They were talking about me, basically. I can say that because over the years I found out that I'm smart in a lot of areas, but there are certain areas where I'm as dumb as a fence post, man. And shop is one of them. And I had a shop teacher who had been teaching shop for, I don't know, 35, 40 years. And his name was Mr. Cox. And he did not like me. It just was a personality clash. I didn't particularly care for him that much because I was a nervous wreck around all these saws and electric drills and all the stuff that's in the shop area. And that was his domain. He ruled that. One day, in front of the whole class, he said, "Ray, you know what? All the years I've been teaching, you are probably the worst student I've ever had." Now, this is what I'm talking about. Today, I could probably be a millionaire, you know, because a teacher humiliates somebody like that today, man, it's front page news. But back then, you just dealt with it. I was embarrassed, humiliated, angry, but it wasn't nothing I can do about it. You know, I just kind of like hung my head. Damn, that's a lot of students to be the dumbest, to be the worst, you know. And then to follow it up, and this is true. To follow it up in front of the whole class, he said, "Hey, look, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to go talk to first, second, third floor janitors, see if they got a board stretcher laying around somewhere because I need it." And I said, "All right." You know, so I walked out and I started thinking, a board stretcher? I mean, because even as dumb as I was at 15, I'm thinking, a board stretcher? You know, and I started thinking, okay, maybe there's some kind of a clamp or something, and they spread some oils or something on it, and they can maybe stretch it a thousandth of an inch, or, you know, I didn't know, you know. You don't know when you're 15 years old, you don't know if, you know, a 70-some-year-old teacher tells you to go find a board stretcher, you're off and looking, you know. So I'm having fun, you know. I'm walking around up and down the halls and stuff, and I find the first floor janitor, and I asked him, and he said, no, he didn't have any. That second floor janitor, you know, I'm walking around, I said, you got a board stretcher? You know, and he had this really blank look on his face, and he goes, no, don't have one. Who sent you, Mr. Cox? And I said, yeah. He goes, no, don't have one. And finally, third floor janitor, older guy. I went up and asked him, I said, do you happen to have a board stretcher laying around? And he said, did Mr. Cox send you out looking for a board stretcher? And I go, yeah. He goes, son, there is no such thing. He's playing a joke on you. And I thought, you dog. You dirty dog. You know. I was mad. I mean, I was really kind of upset about it, man. Only because I had to go back in the class. And when I did, everybody was cracking up. He was cracking up. The rest of the class was laughing. Neighbor went looking for a board stretcher. He said, you find one? looking back on it, it's kind of funny, man. It is a kind of stupid board stretcher, man. But like I said, you know, you have no idea when you're 15. And I was not a good student. There's no question about that. I mean, man, I remember I worked at this shoe shining place, man, and they had shoe shine boxes. And so I decided I was going to make a shoe shine box. You know, it's got sides, got a, you know, space down in there. It's got a bottom, and it's got a bar that goes across the top where you kind of like carry it, you know, you put your shoe shine rags and everything in there. I thought, well, man, I'd be able to do that. I screwed that thing up so bad that I ended up taking just the one side of it, which was kind of like triangle shape, like, you know, it kind of like went like this and then down and then like that. And I drilled a hole in the middle of it and ran the cord through it and made a lamp. Ugliest thing I ever seen in my life. But I was not a good student, and I give him that. But to be the worst student and then to send me looking for a board stretcher in front of the whole class, that wasn't cool. Today, I'd have him. Today, I could get him. But not back then. Not back then. And, but in my own way, I suppose I paid him back. Because if I was the worst student that he had ever had in his 35 plus years of teaching, I bet you I also broke more blades than any student he ever had. Because I was a blade-breaking, badass dude. I couldn't, and you break blades by not keeping the blade straight, not keeping the wood straight, and it would snap, it'd break. And I broke a lot of them, man, and they cost money. So I guess I'm number one in a couple categories. And he's long since gone, man, because he was probably around 70 back then. And, but yeah, I went looking for a board stretcher, and I think we all kind of had a little moments of humiliation and stuff like that back then. You just dealt with them, man. Today it would be on the news, you know. Teacher humiliates student. You know, there'd be something. You know, he'd probably go to jail. You know, and he don't deserve to go to jail or something like that. I survived it, you know. So, anyway, this is Ray, the board stretcher neighbor. Gonna sign off. And I learned my lesson. I'm gonna go out with my favorite song, which I always go out with this song a lot of times because it makes me feel good.
Blue Monday, how are you, Blue Monday? Got to work, let go sleep on me.
Here comes Tuesday,
oh, Tuesday. I'm so tired, got no time to play. Here come Wednesday, I'll be to my side. I got home, got to tell that I'm out. Cause Thursday is a hard working day, and Friday I'll get my way.